Hello and welcome to Football Tonight here on the NBC2 Facebook page. I'm Sean Berry. He is Derek Compton. As week 7 of the high school football season kicked off, there were only 2 teams left undefeated in Lee County. So that made our choice for game of the week pretty easy to pick.
And it's hard to believe we're already in week 7, but when you have 2 undefeated, how could it not be an easy decision here? Undefeated South Fort Myers against undefeated Dunbar, and plenty to play for, especially consider the Wolfpack sneaked away with a 1-point win just a season ago.
Sneaked away, snook away, snuck away, whatever it was. It was a 13-12 game last year. Would we see the same affair this time around? Well, South Fort Myers jumped out in front first. Nathan Kaster, yeah, he's a problem. Gone from 28 yards out here to make it 7-0. Sincere Trice would pick off the very first throw that Dunbar would have in this game. And then Nathan Kaster would get the rock and do the exactly same thing. This time from 90 yards out to make it 14-0 South Fort Myers. Second quarter now, Lander Winterbottom throws up a bolt to Anthony Benjamin. He sheds his tackler, and we have a game. It's 14-7. Well, we had a game. This one was paused with 1:50 left in the first half due to lightning with the Wolfpack up 14-13. It resumes tomorrow at 4 p.m., so we still have 2 undefeated teams.
And we will have it, and we will have those highlights. Let's head out to Collier County now with Coach Rick Martin and Naples hosting Atlantic from the East Coast. Second quarter action, the Atlantic quarterback tested this Eagles secondary 1 too many times. He's apparently not been listening to us this time. Eagles pick it off in the end zone. Naples did fumble their next drive, though. They actually trailed 7-6. But didn't trail for long. It took Stanley Bryant Jr. 1 play to get the lead back as he legs out this 80-yard run with those long strides. His Twitter bio says he runs a 4.67. That needs to be a little updated because he was moving right there. The Eagles, they were on top of the half, and that rushing attack that we have seen all season long, it just took over. Kendrick Raphael right there, big physical run, got some more speed to him. Naples, they recover to win this one. Final score, 39-10.
No shutout, though, so no donuts tomorrow morning for the Eagles. Meanwhile, Charlotte crossing county lines to take on Lehigh on Thursday night. This was a good one. Third quarter of a 7-0 game. How about Alex Gonzalez coming down with a prayer of a throw? Gets one, maybe 2 feet in bounds. That is one of the best catches you'll see at any level. But they would have to punt. So would Charlotte. But on the next Lehigh possession, Doran Mallory is picked off by Chris McNeely, and he's running back the other way. That drive would end in a 1-yard Keon Jones touchdown to tie the game at 7. So in the fourth quarter, who do you dial up when you need a touchdown run? Mr. Richard Young, over 150 yards last night, breaks the 1,000-yard plateau for the first time in his high school career. And from there on out, the Lehigh defense would take care of the rest. Lightning hang on to win 14-7. They are for real.
Let's get some more Thursday night football action going for you. This was at Edison Stadium, Fort Myers against Cape Coral. This was a makeup game. First quarter action, Carson Esposito tries to roll out, finds his receiver, but Vincent Clasetti nearly picks that ball off. A heads-up play. Regardless, he'd want that one back. The little slide there. Goodness there.
Yeah, got to watch out.
Got to watch out for the turf there. That would force a Greenies field goal attempt, though. Just a chip shot from Bailey Russell. 3-0 Greenies lead. Ensuing Seahawks drive, Justin Cherniak refuses to go down. The sophomore was a problem for that Greenies defense last night, but Fort Myers has a stable of backs as well and a very strong offensive and defensive line. Ricardo Noel shows off his speed on the next Greenies possession, puts a 15-yard touchdown on Fort Myers. They would pull away in this one. Final score 22-7.
How about we head out to the scoreboard next, because we're going to show you the North Fort Myers just too much in a rain-soaked affair with Island Coast tonight. Trinity Catholic the same over Bishop Vereau. Port Charlotte in a battle of the Buccaneers. The Pirates beat the Raiders by 5.
And back down in Collier County, in the last 2 weeks, the Palmetto Ridge Bears, they've been outscored 88-7. And big surprise here, those were in back-to-back losses.
That's not very good. Not exactly the recipe of success, but a chance at redemption was on the menu tonight as Palmetto Ridge, they usually are interested more in maybe salmon. You know, Bears, they kind of like salmon. Well, tonight they were going to feast on some shark, especially who?
And this
Wade
was
Booker.
Homecoming night for the Bears in a beautiful sunset. And Sean said it, sushi dinner for everyone planning there in black and green. I'm not sure what the diet of Jaden Smiley Booker is, but I'm going to guess he had a happy meal before the game. He was smiling all night long against this Gulf Coast defense. That was a near 50-yard run. He added another one right here in that first half to push the lead to 16-0. Booker had 325 rushing yards and 4 touchdowns in this one. Over 1,000 yards for the season as well. But if the Bears wanted to win, we talked about a pregame, they had to force some turnovers. They did exactly that. The Sharks had a fumble, a safety, and a pick on their first 3 drives. Well, we're having sushi tonight for dinner, boys. Final score, 43-31, Palmetto Ridge back in the win column.
That's a high-protein sushi, you know. That's probably on every football player's diet. How about we head up to the East Lee Arena next? Jaguars taking on Mariner. Tritons were going to punt, but were they? Kevin Jimenez finds Jeremy Mora after he plays hot potato with himself for the first down. P.J. Gibbs, though, not very happy with his defense on that one. However, on the next Tritons possession, still a scoreless game. Kenneth Frazier, this will make P.J. Gibbs very happy. He tackles that quarterback for a loss, and Mariner would have to punt. Ensuing Eastley drive, you know what? Just pitch it on out to Jeff Rinville. He will do the rest. Finds a corner, and he finds some freedom right there. 80-yard house call to draw first blood, and Eastley outlasts Mariner 14-13.
Let's take another look at the scoreboard really quick. Community School of Naples, they've remained perfect on the year. 41-3, a win over Canterbury. Clewiston, a 31-14 win against Cypress. Let's take Clewiston again. They're looking like, a real deal this year. But Champagnat Catholic, just too much for Baron Collier at the Paradise Sports Complex tonight. That final score, 41-23.
Hey, how about one more highlight? We haven't seen Lemon Bay at all this season. Well, up at Veterans Stadium, they were taking on Sarasota Booker. And in the first, following a touchdown off their first drive, Trey Rutton connects with Aaron Pasek down the sideline for the Lemon Bay touchdown. Manta Rays lead 14-0. Manta Rays, they were just putting on an absolute clinic again. Pasek again this time around. This time looked like on a little end around right there. Lemon Bay, way too much for Booker tonight, 57-6. Manta Rays still undefeated, now at 5-0. Quickly back out to the scoreboard real quick. How about the Gateway Eagles, Derek? Their first win as a varsity program in regular season history. They take down Marco Island Academy 42-7. CSN also undefeated. I can't wait for that FBA matchup. They take down Canterbury tonight. And First Baptist Academy, like I said, also undefeated. We got a clash of undefeated that play, what, two blocks away from each other coming up in a couple of weeks?
You can see each other practice, basically. One more scoreboard tonight right here for you. And we're going to go St. John Newman Celtics. We talked about that one. 41-0, big win over Oasis. Golden Gate, a win against IMG Blue. IMG has about, 20 teams. But regardless, that's a big win right there for Golden Gate, 21-13. And Immokalee, looks like that first half was postponed. But Immokalee on top of Moorhaven, 20-0. Again, that was a win. Really wanted to see from that team. You don't root for anybody, but of all programs we'd like to see get a turnaround, that would be Immokalee. So, John, overall, I mean, unfortunately, we were struck by the weather bug yet again, but your impressions of the night?
It is an absolute dogfight in the canines versus felines battle over there in Dunbar. So, you know, if it has to take 2 days, why not? We'll go back out and we'll get those highlights, and we'll have them on here at NBC2 News at 6 p.m. tomorrow night. Well, actually, no, game won't be over probably.
Probably
have them by 11 p.m. I don't want to write a check my mouth can't cash. So, you know. But that'll be a great game. It's 14-13 headed into halftime with about a minute 50 left and change. So it's going to be a good finish.
Yeah, I was really happy to see Naples. It's good to see someone face a little bit of adversity. Hadn't faced too much so far this year, obviously.
10 points, and we're calling it adversity.
But, hey, losing at one point and immediately recovered. And I'm going to tell you, it was they were down. They were turning the ball over. I only got there in the second quarter. I believe they turned the ball over their first two possessions, something like that. So they had a rough start to the game. But immediately recovered, 39-10 win. So Naples still there, but hey, gave a little breathing room to everybody else that they, if they can force some mistakes, you never know.
Last thing I want to mention, Jaden Booker, Richard Young, who is going to be the Southwest Florida rushing champion by the end of the year. Richard Young at 150 last night. Jaden Booker at 325 tonight. I think Booker's still in the lead, so Richard Young has some catching up to do, but I think they meet in a couple of weeks, so the lead might change at some point. That would be fun to watch. That's it for football tonight here on the NBC2 Facebook page. Thank you so much for sticking through the weather delays with us tonight. For Derek, I'm Sean. Have a great night, Southwest Florida, and stay safe out there.